Hi everybody. Hi everybody. Welcome back to Sharon from Vivid Days. I hope you're going to enjoy watching this video. So you're going to see it in two stages. The first stage is when I was in my old house, and the final stage is where I'm in my new house. So you might be saying, Sharon, why has your environment changed, or why does it look like you're working on different things? Well, that's the answer. So I originally started my Hearts of the Oceans and this little piece on a live Blue Peter style video. So if you've not seen that back, I encourage you to go back, because I give you step by step on how I create the basis of this and then come and do layer one and layer two. And this video, because it was Blue Peter style, I had one that I'd prepared earlier, exhibit start, middle and end. Whereas on that video, you never got to see the full process. This video finishes off the stage two and three of the remaining two. And it also shows you how I finished these. So I now have three of these available. They're on MDF. All I've got to do is remove my tape and my nipples, but they are good to go. They have a little cute starfish. And this is my leftovers. So I have been putting my leftovers into a silicone mold, and I've managed to get a dome effect. And it's smooth, but I've just got one little nipple at the back that leaked over, and I've got to redo that. But there's some pretty amazing, cool effects in this one. And then I've got three slightly different versions of this. So that's number one. Excuse me. Number two. And number three. So if you're interested in purchasing any of those, contact me. I've got all the information in the description underneath. Thumbs up, subscribe, share, comments are always welcome. I love to interact with you. If you've never used resin before, I've got a few tutorials that are step by step. Pop back and see some of those. So you'll have the Hearts of the Ocean live. You'll have video 107, Sharon, which is a one teething, which is a one-on-one how I do my resin stages. Now, as I've said throughout this, however you choose to do your resin art is up to you. Whatever process you choose to follow is up to you. This is me just sharing my creative space with you. There are many artists out there that have amazing pieces of work that get there in their own way. So with resin, it's very hard to replicate, but put your own spin on it, work with a feeling. Anyway, I'm digressing. I wasn't even meant to be talking about this now, just introducing myself. I've got to go to work now. It's another beautiful sunny day. We've only got one day until we start to get the kids over from Australia, and then we go on our travels to Greece. So super excited. I should be very inspired with more ocean scenes, and I've got some other projects that I'm working on behind the scenes. Anyway, I'm Sharon. I've digressed. I always do, let's face it. Anyway, watch the end of this video and I'll see you on the next one. Have a lovely day. Yep, digressed again. Hi everybody, welcome back to Sharon from Vivid Days. So if you did watch my live video last Sunday, you would have seen me doing it in Blue Peter style, where I had three hearts at three different stages, start, middle and end. So I'm coming back to finish my middle and ends. This one is going to receive its second and final layer. This one is going to receive its first layer, and then I will do a second one. And then I will come back and show the effects. But for people that don't want to watch live and watch all that commentary, this is an ideal way for you to see them. So these are an MDF heart that I got off Etsy. They're quite a thick one. I tape up my back, make sure it's level. I then come in with acrylic paints. Now, I use the acrylic paints as part of my primer, but it also helps map out where I am going to put my resin colour, and it also helps add a little bit of depth, as you can see through some of the pigments. So I am going to make sure that these are both leveled. They are both going to use the same paints that I use on my base. So today I am going to be using Darla and Rowney, which is ultramarine, a Peabo, which is a cyan, the Peabo Studio, which is a green blue, and a Peabo turquoise. and I bring in my waves with Casting Craft White. This one's nearly run out, so I've got it upside down. I use the same pigments that I use on my base. Now, the reason I use the acrylic paint is just for me, these ones respond really well in a resin, and it's something that helps me attach to the oceans that I'm used to over in Australia when I lived there for 16 years. You can choose to use pigments or whatever color you use. Just remember, resin hates water and acrylic is made out of water. So different brands may respond differently. So if you prefer to use pigments, you use pigments. In the back there, you can see I've got a silicone tray. I would recommend you using it. So when I did the other layers, I just popped in my silicone and it's in there, and I'll add the rest of the colors there and you'll get a beautiful way to capture your resins and not have any waste. Tools of the trade, I'm going to be putting my gloves on, double gloves, so that you can remove your gloves anytime without getting that resin on your hand. I have got my respirator, so once I put this on, I will make sure that I do voiceovers for this. I've got my blowtorch, and I also have a heat gun, and they're the main tools of trade. I've got this tiny little skew here, which helps me pick out the dust particles. My conservatory has been a bit warm today, so I've got the door open, which means there's a high chance there's gonna be dust, but I'm not gonna worry too much if I get it on this one, because I will be coming in with a second layer and that will cover up dust. This one I wanna protect, so I've got my top ready to cover it. I've got real sand, because I'm Sharon, I digress, and I like to use real sand. And I've got my two cute little starfishes that I will dip in my silicone before adding. Sorry about my nails, I've been working in the studio all day today, making the most of my day off work, my main job. So I am just gonna level these. Once I'm happy that these are level, I am going to start with this. You may ask if I'm gonna sand this one back. No, because it was only 2 days ago I worked on this. So if I add my master cast to this now, which is the resin I'm using, it will cling to it beautifully and there will be no issues. If you prefer to sand it, sand away. And other than that, I'm not going to talk now. I'm just going to get on with it, level it, and watch my process, and I will do my best to talk through. Now, I've been asked before what are the measurements I'm using, and I'm a bit reluctant to give you the measurements I'm using, because it's all going to depend on the brand you're using. It's all going to depend on the size of the canvas that you're using. I use the resin calculator online and measure my project, and that should give you an idea, as well as follow your manufacturing guides. I tend to work slightly over rather than under, only because I usually have silicone molds to one side to work on projects, but that's a personal choice. Resin's expensive, we all know that, so you've just got to make the most of it. Just making sure there is no dust over there. You know, I've been kept to one side. Just want to make sure. And we will start to mix our resin. Thank you. Hi, welcome back to Sharon from Vivid Days. So the video you are watching was in two halves. Half of this was done in my old rental before we moved into our new house. And I believed I managed to get the second coats done on these two. But there's just a little bit of imperfections to them because I was rushing. And you might say, what is that, Sharon? What is that imperfection? I don't know. I just feel like with these ones, I do like how, you know what? No, I'm contemplating, do I need to give these a flush coat? I think I'm all right with that one. I'm looking at this one here. This one definitely does. The wave, the second layer dissipated. So I believe this one, and it's got a little mark there, which was created in the move. So I'm gonna rework that one, almost give it a second layer. And then with this one here, it needs its second layer. It's only had one layer, so, and the starfish needs attaching. So same process as earlier in the video, but you're just gonna get to see me finish this. You'll then see how I remove my resin nipples and get these ready for selling. And this is the one where I was using my leftovers, and it's created a stunning effect. So I'm gonna sand around here and just create a dome on that, and that one's finished. And I am gonna sand these two lightly where I'm adding the other coat, and that one I think I'm just gonna leave as it is. I can't make it any better and I might ruin it. So I will fast forward you this process. The colors are the same colors that I've been using earlier, so no need to repeat that. I'm just showing you, apologize, my window of the full process. So let me just have a little look at this one. I'm looking for dust particles, I'm looking for depth, and I actually quite like the way that that one's rolling over and it's sealed all around the edges. So, and I can't see any dust particles or scratches, so that one got through the move successfully. So that one's done, but I will keep it in view just because it is part of the set, and these ones will be available for sale if you're interested. So I'm gonna come in now and lightly sand these. I'll move this one out of the way just while I'm sanding so I don't get dust on there. The reason we're lightly sanding is this has been 5 weeks since I worked on these with a move. So the resin needs something to grip to. So it's important that you give it a little bit of surface and just lightly sanding it, just enough to get those little knocks in there. And scratches will be enough for that resin to cling to. And what I will do is come back with some alcohol wipes and just remove all the debris and dust particles. So this one, again, just the surface. I do love the effects on this one. Who knows, there might be some resin left over that I need to put in here. But I am going to get around the edges here, because I do want to make sure there's no hard surfaces when I join my dome to it from the outside. I could have chose to leave it in the mould, but didn't want to do that because I really do just want to get that dome effect, and I don't want to risk anything running down the side once I've removed it from the mould. Anyway, I'm Sharon, I'm digressing. Let me wipe these down now and check that they are level, and let's commence the final stage. Now, because this is only an alcohol wipe with 70% alcohol in there, you can leave a little smear. So I just come in with a damp, very slightly damp cloth, and then wipe that dry just to remove any streaks. And you need to make sure you have removed all your water because resin hates water. Make sure there's no bits that's come off the edge. So when I start using my heat gun, blowtorch,
all good, and I won't be kicking in any glitter for this. All right, check it's all level, damp off. I'm using my Love Art silicone cup. Pretty cool, and I've ordered more silicone cups, so you will see me still using some of these. These are leftover party cups from many years ago at children's party. I am still conscious of the environment, that's why I'm recycling and reusing these, but I've got more silicone coming because the ones I did used to use absolutely loved, used them for a year, but then they just started to crack and wear away and need replacing. But hearts of the ocean with a hearts of the ocean stirring cup. I'll see you on the other side of stirring. The first thing I'm going to do is dunk my starfish into some clear resin. The reason being, I want it to have a good coat, and when I put it there, I want to make sure that there's no air bubbles underneath, and I don't want to forget him. So he's going on, he's been dipped in resin, and I'm hoping he's going to stay where he is. So I remember I need to add clear here, because this has not had its second coat of sand, and I do use real sand, so we'll put some of that on soon. But at the minute, I am just putting some clear on here, and then I will come back with some sand. Some real sand, and I'm just going to shake it backwards and forwards. Should be it for that. Let that absorb in. Okay, so I'm going to pour in a little bit of my resin for ultramarine blue. This is going to go on both pieces. Down and around the ultramarine blue. As I've mentioned before, please remember resin does not enjoy water. So I only add a pea size drop at the most. Even that might be a bit too much for the amount of resin I'm using. So you have to make sure you apply it quickly, and that'll stop it going marshmallowy and thermal, which means causing the resin to cure quick, a very quick pace. Make sure it is all stirred in though. And then I'm gonna pop it in the areas. Now I might need to add a bit more, but I'm just going to do this. Taking it over the edge so it's going to fall. Not quite that nice edge. This one, it's important I do the edges as well, because it's only had one coat, and this will just help seal that MDF. The other one's already had that, so I'm not too concerned about doing it, but I am very mindful I don't want to ruin my other piece. It's like layering a cake, icing it. Ice, ice, baby. Okay, so that should be it, but I'm just going to drag a few little lines down, same with this one, just to merge it through with some of the other colours, and just checking my edges, and I'm not going to get rid of the bubbles until it's all on there. Need to pay a bit more attention to the edges and that. Oh, she got it on there. I'm just going to take this one out of the way. It's going to be one of those days. Put it in safe harm way. Oh my gosh, come on, Sharon. All right. Okay, is, and I'm getting as much out as I can, is I want to recycle this cup. And because it's all going to be blues in that, it's just going to dilute and bring the tones through, which should be nice. Same amount now I will get rid of my sticks though. Let's see, and wash those and recycle those. So I'm going through to my cerulean blue again, a little bit less than I put in last time. This one really, some acrylics respond okay to resin and some really don't, and that's just the different brands and how they're made up on the water. So I've put slightly less in this one. One, because it's got the blue tones in there anyway, which should drag through, but also this one does tend to go a little bit marshmallowy quicker than the other one. That's quite nice, got that tone coming through. So I'm just gonna bring that through here. Need to remember my edge again. I'm going to come through now with the green blue. Again, changing stick. Add a little bit more. Same amount. So I've only mixed up 200 mils of resin, and there is going to definitely be some left over. Blue green. This one is more transparent, translucent. So I tend to add a slightly more than the other ones. This does play really nice with resin, but again, I'm sure it's going to have its limitations. I'm using the same cup, so it's going to bring through a few more of those tones that we've just been working with. Those precious edges. last but not least, turquoise. Not bringing it too far forward though, because we have to be mindful of. Probably can use that stick again because the tones are very similar. Turquoise. Oh, a little bit too much turquoise there. Might just put half of it in. It fell out, I'm afraid. Leave that on there, give that a wipe down. I'm mindful not to get too near the edges because the white is going to push some of these colours out. I mean, you can see that there's already some dripping off, but don't worry about that. That I knew that would happen because I want to get my edges to complete these, and it's minimum wastage. And I'll scoop it up and put it inside a silicone mold to start layering like I did for this one here. Just get throw that and save 3 cups. All right, what I want to do is make sure it's clear here. So I'm just going to flatten that now. Make sure that joins. Just leaving a little touch point for where the white is going to go, but again bringing it around the edges, don't forget those edges. Just a little more here. Let's come around with the edges. That to one side, and I am going to mix up a little bit of the white. Hardly need any white compared to the rest, and the white is going to be Casting Craft. Well used, well loved. It's good at helping you create cells as well, so you just need 1 or 2 drops. A little goes a long way. It's concentrated. I think I've got enough, or if I need to mix more in. Right, and just place some thin lines where you want your waves to be. No rhyme or reason, your art, your way. tend to leave a little bit of a line between them because that's how I find, I mean personally, it creates a little bit more depth because you're getting lights and darks mixed in. But again, personal choice, your art, your way. And you might want to add a little bit more white in one area because that's where you feel that the wave is caressing higher. You might not. Running with a set of three. When you're in Australia, you tend to see sets of three. Not always. Do a little bit more at the front. So I do need more white then. So I'll just mix a little bit more up, but at the minute I'm going to add a little bit of the foam where it's come onto the beach in my imagination. Starfish. Alright, need to mix a little bit more up. Then I'm good to dome the other end. Alright, we are going to give this, get rid of the air bubbles then come in with a blowtorch, but I'm removing my gloves so I don't get it too sticky. So I like that a lot. Love the emotions in that. I might just come through with a tiny little bit more white here. Maybe here. And definitely here. So I'm just going to check for bubbles, dust particles, and I am just going to come and layer this, dome it, bubble it, done. And then I'm going to leave whatever silicone resin is left in here to set because it creates a little heart mold, which is kind of cool. Just going to see how we're going here and help it to the edges. Do want it to dome. Don't want it to go over the edges. Pay attention to my edges now. And hopefully it's going to start running off. I might need to pull that a little bit further this way because I'm going to keep playing with it for a little bit. any bits going over the edge and creating resin nipples. That won't be good. So you don't need to see me babysit this. All I am going to do is keep circling my finger around it, because as I say, there is, I have to add another one. I don't want any drip offs, but I did want that dome. I've got the dome. I just need to make sure there's a little bit of excess running off, and I just need to make sure that's not going to stay underneath and ruin my piece. And I'll just keep circling it till it starts to set. So I will come back and show you if this has been a success. So see you on the other side of curing.
Hi, welcome back to Sharon from Vivid Days. These three pieces are done. I can do no more. They have their own personalities. There are some parts that I love more than others, but overall, I love them all. They represent the ocean from the colours and the feels of the water crashing. Some are slightly more misty and some are more power. This has got a little bit of them all, and this is the leftovers that I had. So I'll bring you in to the first one. You can see the depth of the other ocean first piece that I did rolling through and the splashing up. And this one looks like the wave has just crashed and that starfish is peeping through. So I've just got to come back and remove these resin nipples. So I put tape on all of mine. All I need to do is go backwards and forwards with a heat gun until it heats up no more than 10 seconds in each section. And that tape will pull off and take the resin nipples with them. So pretty hassle-free. Number two, this one has got more emphasis and more stronger white pigment coming through, and it held it, it's dripping over the edge, but it has a little bit more 3D effect in that one, but the starfish is peering at the top right corner. On to the third and final, very similar feel, more like number two. You can still see the splashing and you can see the misty water just floating over that sand and that starfish peering through. This was the leftovers where I kept adding it to my mold, and it's created some pretty striking effects. And it definitely shows you don't throw away any of your leftovers. Use your silicone mold. So I do have a nice little dome all the way around here, but I have got one nipple there. I'm just going to sand that down and smooth that out. But look at the effects on that. These will be available for sale, so first come, first serve. If you're interested, make contact with me. But other than that, thumbs up, subscribe, share. Comments are always welcome. And I'm hoping to be more inspired when I get back from my Greece holiday and create some more ocean vibes with you. And if you are interested in any of my ocean pieces, if it's not already been sold, connect with me, because I can make your very own piece just for you. And I wonder if I'm going to bring any shells back with me. I think I will. Anyway, I'm Sharon. I've digressed. It's been a pleasure hanging out with you. I hope you've got a lot from this video. And I'll see you on the next one, where I'm hoping to be slightly more relaxed.